Why study molecular communication? What's the point? I've been doing research in molecular communication engineering for over 10 years. When I introduce this field of study, this question comes up again and again. Now, it is a fair question. People both inside and outside the communication engineering community wonder what benefit could we possibly achieve by understanding communication schemes that use molecules. They already exist in living systems, and they're too slow to replace modern wireless technologies, so why should engineers care? I'm going to try to answer that in this video. I'm going to summarize the motivation for molecular communication engineering, which I introduced in a previous video. You can check out the link in the video description. Then I'll introduce problems along the three directions of research that molecular communication could help us solve. Molecular communication can be seen to sit at the interface between communication engineering and the biosciences. Most research in this area will either borrow ideas from biology to design whole new communication devices and systems, or apply communication engineering principles to biological systems, or both if we're trying to build devices that can listen and talk to cells. I'm going to list some applications along each of these three directions. Let's start with new communication systems. Some applications are environments where conventional wireless technologies are hard to deploy, for example, due to physical or scalability limitations. Challenges might include poor spreading of wireless signals, needing very small devices, or needing to install an extremely large number of devices. If we can build small radios that communicate using molecules, then we might be able to overcome these limitations. Living cells already have these capabilities. They're small, they operate in large numbers, and they signal with molecules. So we can learn from them to engineer new devices. The applications that are proposed to benefit from this approach tend to be industrial, like designing mobile sensors for airborne pollution monitoring, or robots for precise nanoscale manufacturing. Now let's consider understanding biological systems. Inside our bodies, our cells use molecules to communicate in many ways. I did a previous video on examples of molecular communication in cell biology. You can check it out using the link in the video description. There are opportunities for us to apply communication theory to understand how communication takes place and measure how effective it is. At minimum, this could help us to understand and appreciate how the body works. But that's not all. Many diseases manifest as a breakdown in healthy communication between cells, or the development of unhealthy communication. For example, neurodegenerative diseases usually involve nerve cells becoming less effective at signaling, whereas bacterial infections and cancerous tumors develop under the coordination and therefore communication of undesired cells. If we can model these communication scenarios, then we could engineer and test strategies to maintain or restore healthy signaling. This segues nicely to the third research direction of building devices that can listen and talk to cells. New medical testing, diagnostics, and treatments could be developed by creating an interface with the cells in our bodies or in experimental platforms like lab-on-a-chip systems. The devices could be genetically modified cells or specially designed robots and sensors that have biochemical components. They could be used to monitor cell signaling at a local level, detect when and where problems occur, and take actions to resolve them. This may sound futuristic, but contributing to these kinds of technologies is a major long-term goal for the molecular communication research community. It will take a lot of work and the collaboration of many fields of research, so stay tuned. So which application do you think is most promising? You can let me know in the comments below. You can like the video and subscribe if you want to see more content on biophysical communication engineering. Thanks for watching. See you next time.